Hi everyone, I'm James Ayomide, and you're on Outlook Africa. Today in our series of African emerging markets, we discuss Ghana, ranked in 2014 among the five fastest emerging markets in the world. What's going on right in Ghana? In this show, we'll take you to the country providing golden experiences.
Today is all about the African five-star nation, which is now enjoying a particular affection from investors, Ghana. President John Dramani used to say, "Come to Ghana or get late." I'm Yohan, you are on Outlook Africa. Ghana is in West Africa. It borders Ivory Coast to the west, Burkina Faso to the north, Togo to the east, and the Atlantic Ocean to the south. The word Ghana means warrior king, and Ghana is also called the Golden Coast.
Ghana was the first sub-Saharan country in the colonial Africa to gain independence. And currently, Ghana is seen by many as one of the most politically stable democratic in sub-Saharan Africa. Ghana is a country with vast natural resources such as oil and gold.
Right, Ayo. Ghana is a fascinating country since its past history. Why do we call Ghana the Golden Coast? It's because its soil provides immense reserve of gold. This is a country which has gained a lot from its past. Today, business in Ghana is booming.
Yeah, you're right, Yohan. And always remember that diamonds are ladies' best friends. Ladies are always excited to live in the Golden Coast. Yohan, tourism is a booming sector in Ghana. With its breathtaking beaches and little restaurants, Ghana is a very friendly country. Ideal for the first-time travelers to Africa, the people are generally very helpful and welcome in Ghana.
That's true, Ayo. Tourism is growing very quickly in Ghana. We have many operators who can provide holidays in Ghana. You know, Ghana is becoming a good destination for everyone.
You must have heard about a dance, this song called Azonto. Azonto is a dance born on the street of Accra, which has gone viral nowadays. Even the West people have gone crazy dancing over and over. It's all over the world, not even only in Africa, in America, in everywhere. Seriously.
And Ayo, Azonto is not really difficult to dance. It's simple. If you go to YouTube, you can find some tutorial.
But it's not about this difficulties or simple. It's all about the style of dancing.
Yeah, exactly.
The way people, it's one
it's
kind
simple
of,
but kind of
seriously,
style.
It's something people need to see the video.
It's
awesome. Like the way you do your legs, your move, it's very different from natural, normal dance. Like you just have to shake your body. It's all about shaking. It's so, so good. Seriously. And let's dance with Azonto. We'll see you right after the break on Radio Amity 107.8 FM.
See, I just came back from Ghana.
Really?
And I want to share this dance that everyone was doing over there.
What's the dance?
QB tried to show me how to do it. He sat me down in his place.
And
he said to me, "Fuse." Nobody want to see you rising. And when they do, they don't even like it. They just want to see you deep in crisis. Drive yourself, you don't need a license. Holler her, she can even ride it. Go ahead, move your feet just like this. Then he showed me the latest. We walk over them haters. Now what you do, man, Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto. We walk over them haters. Now what you do, man, Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. So I'ma take you right through this. Azonto dance is the movement. So when you jump on the floor, better use it. First step is a step, step. You can move to the right, to the left, left. You can even freestyle when you step, step. Put your hands in the air and you rep, rep. So go, go, go. Twist your fingers, you can wave.
You're listening to Radio Amity 107.8, and this is still Outlook Africa.
No balance, that's how you do. Let me see you go, go. QB taught me this.
No
Nobody wanna see you rising. And when they do, they don't even like it. They just wanna see you deep in crisis. Drive yourself, you don't need the license. Holler her, she can even ride it. Go ahead, move your feet just like this. Then he showed me the latest. We walk over them haters. Now what you do, man, Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto, Azonto, Azonto. Now watch me do my Azonto.
To blow, move to the rhythm. Here we go. I'll show you how to do this. So, yeah. Some insa, menkasa, up across and the south side. Move to the left and right and watch me free. Azonto. All my ladies try to pose and free. Trafoto. Drop it low and make the boys say, Akosombo. Freestyle it the way you want to say, Uchimo.
What you do, my Azonto? Azonto, Azonto. Now, watch me do my Azonto.
Everybody enjoyed this song, and we are discussing today the Ghana's emerging market. Let's welcome to the show our colleague Ojo Oyeendah. Welcome to the show, and our audience has been missing your voice. We're happy to have you on the program.
Oh, thank you, Miss Ayo, the golden voice.
Ojo, our audience is excited to know today what's going right in Africa, Golden Nation.
As we said on our last show, the booming in Africa has not been China but telecom. I think everybody knows that.
Yeah.
The 23% of Ghanaian population in 2011 were using mobile broadband. And Ghana is coming particularly with mobile industry. I think everybody knows that because they're very, very good in communication. When you talk of like information technology, they're very, very good in it. Statistics shows that an estimated amount of 16 million mobile phones are used in this country with 25 million citizens, with many owning more than one SIM card. On the other side, Ghanaian developers are also performing well in smartphones industry, like all these dual SIM, like I think you know that. And Ghana has been the first country in Africa to build its own smartphone, 100% made in Ghana. I think that is very, very wonderful and awesome.
Yeah,
I think they're really trying their best.
Yeah.
And I think it's easy to understand when we know that in Ghana they are doing courses like BCA.
Yohan, everybody thinks phones are all made in China, US, Japan, because now, but when Ghana came up with the idea of information technology, finding a source of making a phone, then SIM card,
exactly.
That is really awesome. As in,
yeah.
A kudos to them.
Yeah,
seriously.
Yeah.
That can show us how Africa is going up.
Yeah. And what makes Ghana a fast-growing country is the fact that the country has been able to build a stable economy. I mean, over the last two decades, Ghana has prospered under a stable democratic system of government. This economy has grown annually by around 6% each year, making it one of the undisputed sources in Africa.
Wow.
And you know, it's helping Africa, it's helping the growth of Africa
rather. Very, very, like it's really helping.
With improved economic stability and transparency, Ghana now qualifies for substantial debt relief measure. You know, it's really helping when you have a country, you know, when they are doing good things, I mean, it's a pride for that nation. It's a pride for people from there, and even people who are like now in Africa generally. It's a pride for us that a country is doing this. I mean, people is only believing that China phone.
Yeah,
but when phone is having glasses.
Every phone I not only for China.
Yeah.
Now phone made in Ghana.
Yes. Now we know that.
Yeah. It's new to everybody. I mean, it might be new to most people that Ghana has their own phone industry. But now it's not new again.
But,
I think everybody knows.
Well, hi, I want to ask you a question. Hope that Ghana phone or Ghanaian phone, hope when you on it, hope it's not going to play Azoto, Azoto.
Maybe, no.
Maybe you're just playing Azoto. But I'm very sure it's just good and the best.
Yeah, yeah.
We talk about phone in Ghana. But it's not the only thing. Ghana is also good in agriculture. You know, they employed half of the population in that sector only, agriculture. And they used to export like sugar and so many things.
Yeah.
So I think agriculture
like,
is good.
Yeah, cashew,
cashew.
Like
palm
oil,
The rubber is very good.
Even cocoa butter, yeah.
And cocoa, you know, from cocoa.
Yeah, cocoa
even,
butter.
Even the cocoa butter, they have the cream too. When you use
and
it
even,
for body cream,
even Ghana is the second.
It's very good for black shining people.
Yeah,
very good.
Ghana is the second largest producer of cocoa butters, this cocoa bean in the world. Yeah, even if you go to this, even in India also, there are books like if you check, they write the geography of some source of drugs or some source of those plants.
Yeah,
it's just they know this that when it comes to cocoa beans, Ghana is very good. This coconut and all, it's you know. Really making and this kind of when it comes to agriculture, it's making good incomes. You know, agriculture is a very good thing when it comes to income. It helps a lot.
Let's not forget to quote that one of the amazing things in Ghana is the yellow gold and black diamond. Like
really?
Seriously, yeah, yellow gold and black diamond. In 2008, gold exports were valued at $2.2 billion. That is money.
Oh yeah,
big money.
Seriously.
And however, Ghana's government received only around $160 million, 5% of that wealth. Like seriously, that was money. And gold mining in Ghana has a history dating back to the 15th century. Like to this date, the country remains the African second largest producer of metal. Such of the gold wealth goes to the foreign mining companies, but custom duty on gold look to set increase on it.
In 2007, we found new oil reserves in Ghana, and people were quite happy. This oil discovered is likely to earn the country $1.2 billion each year, providing an important boost to the economy.
Yeah. You know, we are living in a world dominated by a huge demand of energy, and such discoveries make people happier and confident about their tomorrow. You know, being in the present and seeing your future, seeing your tomorrow that is bright, it's something that encourages youths. I mean, especially, it even encourages the parents, the people in the country. I mean, it's something good.
You know, Ayo, people are looking for other sources of energy. We have like electric one and all those things, but still, when the country has oil, it's very important for its economy, because oil, we are not going to like stop using oil like this.
Seriously?
Yeah, we still have maybe 15 years using oil. Oil is very important, so when you have oil, you can do something very good for your economy.
Seriously. I mean, even that's why the youth of nowadays, most of them in university, they read this course, because after everything, they won't start eating that money in oil and all those things. Seriously, everybody want to be rich. We're enjoying a great discussion today about Ghana. And here on Outlook Africa with her, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back on Radio Amity 107.8 FM. Enjoy this beautiful Ghanaian music.
Why are you so crack, crunk, crunk? Oh, come here now, who are mommy? me tam for me tam for je dam in amin kwa o kare me ho do do ti sa sumare na sa me jia si akum me sa sore o kran zuro o ya o wanzi me tam for we dam ye o re u za u dam ye me tam for we dam ye o kran me tam for me tam for je dam in amin kwa o kare me ho do do ti sa sumare na sa me jia si akum me sa sore din zuro o ya o wanzi me tam for we dam ye re u za u dam ye me tam for we dam ye ba ba la 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 mi ni anunti je ni amudi ye mi mi ni senti je ni amudi ye mi
to Radio Amity 107.8 and this is still Outlook Africa.
Me tam for je dam in amin kwa o kare me ho do do ti sa sumare na sa me jia si akum me sa sore din zuro o ya o wanzi me tam for we dam ye re u za u dam ye me tam for we dam ye o kare me tam for me tam for je dam in amin kwa o kare me ho do do ti sa sumare na sa me jia si akum me sa sore din zuro o ya o wanzi me tam for we dam ye re u za u dam ye me tam for we dam ye ba ba la 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 la
what a nice song. We couldn't stop dancing here, especially Yohan shaking his head and higher. It's all about the African Five Stars Nation, Ghana. Welcome back to the program.
Now let's bring things every traveler must know about Ghana.
Exactly, Ayo. If you ever travel to Ghana, you should fall in love with these crazy clothes. You know, they have good clothes.
Yeah, especially the fabrics.
Yeah. Ghanaian loves looking nice.
Everybody loves that piece.
Of course.
I'm not a Ghanaian. It doesn't mean I don't love looking nice.
They have kind of creativity.
And me?
You know, they love looking, they love looking clean and fresh, you know.
So what are you guys trying to say?
we can say that they like fashion. They like things when things are shining.
Yeah, they're creative.
Yeah. So you should go there and I think you're going to like it.
Oh, okay.
Ghana is also the best with its cheap hair and cheap black hair stylists. Like when you talk about the braiding your hair has just as much creative freedom as designing clothes. You know, they braid the hair as if they are designing clothes.
Even
now, when you twist the braiding, when you make it straight, when you make it 1 million braid, 2 million braid.
You know, about this braiding of a thing, it's what makes Africa itself unique, stand out. And seriously, because when you make this hair, people look at you outside and start touching your hair.
Exactly.
Please let me see. What have you done today? What
is
happening to you?
Very
you
know, good.
People used to say it's only for ladies, but I used to braid my hairs. And when I came to college, it was just amazing.
Even people used to think, sometimes when we make this hair every day, you know, we have a different look.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Different hairstyles. They think, what happened to your hair today?
Exactly.
You have an haircut. You haven't had this. I want to have this on my hair.
Yeah, you got it.
And let me tell you the funniest part. It's not only black. You can choose any color. either purple, white,
just chocolate brown,
anyone you want. And the funniest part, and to any length, if you like to your toenail, to your back length, any length you want. And the pattern and the texture, like, and the funniest part, that like the making of this year is just 16 Ghana cedis. And I think approximately to US dollar, that is $16. That is so cheap.
That is cheap.
That
yes.
is so cheap. So like $16.
Cheap and you look nice.
Actually. And unique.
I look like just $16.
That is so lovely. And
I think I'm going to keep my hair and do it again.
Oh, maybe you should try that.
Okay. If you travel to Ghana, don't forget to enjoy its landscape. Thankful Ghana has a lot of varieties in its landscape. In Brong Ahafo, you got a sunset to a tropical savanna when you ride your bike home along its small hills.
Oh, wow.
You know,
I feel good.
You feel good. Oh, that is nothing because, you know, in Ghana, they have so many good foods. You should try the food because people used to say they have so good food.
Like this food and kentumere.
Do you know what it is?
Yeah, it's made of this cocoyam leaf. It's yummy. Seriously, you have to have a taste.
Ah.
Seriously.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I've tasted it before because I have a friend which was from Ghana and it's awesome.
Then I'm going to test it.
You have to.
There are many fascinating museums and historical sites to visit in Ghana. If you want this to be the focus of your trip, I could recommend making a stop in the city of Cape Coast. This is where you will find Cape Coast Castle and more other castle, like two or more museums. That's where you can stop and you see Atlantic slave trade, wild art to stomach. A tour of these castle will give you an important lesson in history.
I think that is kind of difficult for you, but it's not easy because, you know, Ghana has big history, you know. Ghana has a huge history. So we can just say people go to Ghana and visit like historic places. It's
and
very interesting. Yeah, for sure. How can you go somewhere and don't see the beach if there is?
We enjoyed having you on How to Look Africa today. If you like the show, stay tuned every day at 2:30 p.m. and 6:30 p.m. for a repeat. You can also download the show on YouTube. Don't forget to like our Facebook page. Outlook Africa is over for today. Goodbye from Noida.
Yeah, 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 y